Brothers and sisters, you can open the Word of God. We're going to read from Matthew 22. Usually we read this scripture passage when we do our prayer of confession. But today we're going to use this as our scripture reading for the sermon. Matthew 22, verses 34 to 40. Bible that I have in front of me, it is on page 1028. Matthew 22 from verse 34. And the message of today is you have to learn to forgive yourself. Listen to this again. This is the last message of our sermon series of Blame and Shame. And it's all about how to learn to forgive yourself. Let us read this together, the greatest commandment. Hearing that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees, the Pharisees got together. One of them, an expert in the law, tested him with this question. Teacher, which is the greatest commandment in the law? Jesus replied, love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. And the second is like it. Love your neighbor as yourself. All the law and the prophets hang on these two commandments. And I want to read from verse 39 again. And the second is like it. Love your neighbor as yourself. All the law and the prophets hang on these two commandments. Brothers and sisters, if you go and do research about suicides in the United States, you will find a lot of statistics. Suicide people that killed themselves. If you go and look at the statistics of murders in the United States, you will find a lot of statistics around that topic. But there's a murder in this world that we're living in that we cannot count. A murder that we cannot see. Which murder is that? How many people do you know? Or maybe today it's yourself. You already passed away. Why can I say that? You already passed away. There was suicide inside yourself. Suicide that nobody else can see. Suicide that nobody else can experience. Why do I say that? We all are human beings. We all have a history. We all have a background. We all have something that we are very shy of in life that we don't want to discuss. It's a topic that we just pass. But in myself, I passed away because of that. In myself, I passed away because I cannot forgive myself for what I did in the past. For some of us, it's maybe easier to move on in life, to go on, to believe that Jesus erased the past. But for a lot of us, it is very hard to put the past behind. If I only said it the other way around. If I only think twice before I do things, if I can just change the past. And because of the past, a lot of us, and psychology prove that, because of the sins of the past, the wrong of the past, we have a low self-esteem. And what does that mean? low self-esteem say, I can have a false image in this world. If people look at me, they can see somebody that's strong physically, but maybe inside you are dead. The suicide happened because of what you did in the past. That's the murder that you cannot count today. Brothers and sisters, and this is what we have to learn today, how to forgive yourself. And help me if I'm wrong today. I don't know where we find that or who taught that to say that we cannot affirm that we are good human beings. Where did it start that we have that in mind, that we cannot say, I love myself? You know what? When I was brought up in life, and my parents and teachers and adults taught me the ways of life, one of the main things is you cannot love yourself too much. Otherwise, you're not going to be humble. So don't love yourself. You're not going to be humble if you do that. Brothers and sisters, if I read the Word of God, I don't find that. I don't find that Jesus says, stop loving yourself. What I find, and if you read Matthew 22, it's loud and clear that Jesus say, let's do a summary of the commandments. The first one is love God and only God. And then listen to the words, and like it. Listen to that word, and like it. Love your neighbor, and then I want you to hear this loud and clear today. Love your neighbor as yourself. If Jesus summarized the law and he say the greatest commandment, part of it is to love yourself like your neighbor. Now we know how important it is to look around to say we have to love each other, we have to love our neighbors with their mistakes, with whichever they did in the past. We have to love them as we love ourselves. Now I want to ask you, how does the love look like if you have to love your neighbor? How does that love look like? Look at yourself. If you love yourself, the way that you have to follow to love your neighbor is first of all to love yourself. So if I understand this correct, the summary of the law, the words of Jesus are saying the following. If you receive the love of God, which he gave all of us by his son, Jesus Christ, and you love God in the first place, that's your first priority, to love God. The second is, how can you love your neighbor if you do not love yourself? If you love yourself, you can easily love your neighbor. Isn't that true? Hate yourself and show me how is it possible to love your neighbor. If you are not okay with who you are, if you don't love yourself, how on earth will you understand love that you have to share with one another? So Jesus is very clear with this. You have to receive the love of God, which he gave you through his son, Jesus Christ. And in return of that, you have to love God. You have to love yourself so that you can love your neighbor. Tell me, brother and sister, why is it that we focus more often on our failures in life? On those things that we are ashamed of? Why is it so hard to focus on our success in life? Why is it so hard to focus on my talents, which I'm good at? Let us dig into this. Remember in Genesis, God, the Creator, created the human being. You know what? After that, he said, oh, I am proud of this. This is good. So the first thing that you have to see in the mirror, if you're going to look at the mirror to see who you are, just listen to the first words of God after he created the human being. He said, this is good. You know what? If we go read the Bible, all the scripture readings about talents and gifts, God give you talents. God give you those powers in life to help others, to strengthen others. It's a gift from God. But remember, we don't really talk about that gift, because if we have to affirm that, we are bragging about our gifts. But it's a gift from God. I want you to understand, if God look at you today, He doesn't look through the same glasses than the world look at you. God look at you as His creation, and He said, this is good. So I want to ask you, if God say you are good, who else can change that? I want to ask you the following. What's the difference then between loving yourself and being self-centered? That's the definitions that we have to look at today if we look at our own lives. Can you love yourself? Yes, you can love yourself. Can you love yourself too much? No, you cannot love yourself too much. Which is the boundaries of love? Ask yourself that today. But there's a difference between loving yourself and being self-centered. What is the definition of being self-centered? Being self-centered is to place yourself in a position higher than the position of God. To take a position of love in life, which is not your position, not your place to be in, but you take the position of God in your life. That's self-centeredness. That is wrong according to the Word of God. But to love yourself is not wrong. God say, love your neighbor as yourself. Maybe you have a past that you are very ashamed of. Maybe you are shy today. Maybe you cannot go forward in a relationship. Maybe you cannot go forward today at your workplace, because of the past, the wrong decision that I've made. I want to tell you today, be honest with yourself. Don't kill yourself. Don't be the murderer of your own murder. I want to ask you today, take the love of Jesus Christ. Take the love of God, and He shared that through His Son on the cross. You don't get a bigger example of love by God giving His Son to you, so you and me can be clean. The past can be erased so that we can love one another, but more important, loving ourselves. You know what's the truth? You cannot run away. You cannot run away from yourself. You cannot leave yourself behind today. You cannot say, I'm waking up, I'm going to work, I'm going to church today, and I'm going to leave myself. You know, yourself is following you the whole day. Followed you yesterday, it will follow you today, it will follow you tomorrow. You cannot escape from yourself. Brothers and sisters, one of the biggest problems in society today is that we have a low self-esteem, a low self-image, because we compare each other. We compare us with other people. God gave you a unique personality. God gave you unique talents for each and everyone. Never in the Word of God you will hear the words, He only shared talents with certain people. He gave each one of us a talent, a gift. And with that gift, we have to go and serve others in love. Love your gift today. Love the way you look today. Appreciate who you are. Remember, if you love yourself, you will thank God and see all the gifts and talents in life as a gratitude. It will not be a brag moment. But if of you are self-centered, when you take the place of God in your life, that is wrong. Then you cannot love. I want to ask you today, don't run away from yourself. Be happy who you are. Love yourself. You cannot do it too much. There's no boundary for love. And brothers and sisters, if this is the last words of the sermon series of Blame and Shame, forgive yourself. And you can remember this, I will be happy. Because if you can forgive yourself, you can forgive others. How is it possible in life to forgive others if you cannot forgive yourself? It's not possible. Start with yourself. Love yourself. God made you and He said, you are good. Forget about the past. God erased that. Live a future with His love and with His grace. I want to ask you, stop blaming and shaming yourself. Cannot change the past. If you do not like yourself, how is it possible to love yourself? Listen to these words. If you do not like yourself, how is it possible to love yourself? God made you, and you are perfect in His eyes. You are His creation, and most of all, you are His child, and that is good. Do not look around and compare you with others. Look at yourself, like yourself, love yourself, and forgive yourself. Because if you want to focus on loving your neighbor, what do you need to do then? You first have to love yourself. Then you can love your neighbor. Brothers and sisters, life is good. Life is great if you can forgive yourself. And like yourself and love yourself. Do not be self-centered. That's a sin. May God bless you.